This week's BFI Player Choice is the film that announced Dario Argento as the new maestro of Italian horror, a stylish 1970s slasher which became the benchmark for generations of giallo thrillers, The Bird with the Crystal Plumage. Uncredited inspiration from Frederick Brown's novel The Screaming Mimi, filmed in 1958 with Anita Ekberg, The Bird with the Crystal Plumage is a heady mix of art and artifice, sexuality and psychology, murder and madness. Eva Renzi is the beautiful Monica, whom Tony Bassanti's American writer Sam witnesses being assaulted in an upmarket gallery. The attacker flees, but the police are convinced it's the same assailant behind a string of serial murders. Sam is a crucial witness who holds the key to the case. If only he could figure out exactly what it is that he saw. An accomplished critic turned screenwriter whose CV included a story credit on Leone's Once Upon a Time in the West, Argento swiftly established himself as a matchless visual stylist. Lends with Beautiful Cruelty by Vittorio Storaro, who would go on to shoot Apocalypse Now and The Last Emperor, The Bird with the Crystal Plumage is full of stunning, startling imagery, from early scenes of Sam trapped between glass doors captured in a voyeuristic frenzy, to the S&M-tinged denouement, a kaleidoscope of twisted forces, both physical and psychological. Alan Jones, author of Dario Argento, The Man, The Myths and The Magic, once famously said that you could take any frame from any Argento film and hang it in an art gallery. So strong was his sense of composition. Nothing is in the frame by accident, a quality he shared with Alfred Hitchcock. From here, Argento would go on to make such giallo classics as The Cat and Nine Tails and Four Flies on Grey Velvet, completing his so-called animal trilogy. And then to change the face of horror with Profundo Rosso, Suspiria, Opera and more. Today, Argento is still regarded as the maestro of the macabre. This is where it all began.